Welcome to the only daily podcast focusing on compliance news of the day. Each morning, start your day with a cup of coffee and Tom Fox, the voice of compliance, to hear about four of the top compliance, corruption, or leadership stories you will need to start your day. The Daily Compliance News is a production of the Compliance Podcast Network.
May 15, 2020, the Pots and Kettles edition. First up, from the Wall Street Journal, Risk and Compliance Journal, Dylan Tokar reporting. The Securities and Exchange Commission has charged two companies over statement about coronavirus testing. The regulators were concerned about alleged misleading statements made to investors about products intended to help combat the coronavirus. Turbo Global Partners and Applied Biosciences were charged Thursday for having issued news releases that contained false and misleading information about finger prick tests and thermal scanning equipment used to detect the virus. Turbo Global's chief executive was also charged in participation in the alleged fraud. The statements issued by the company could influence their stock price, and this is part of the SEC's ongoing fight against fraud in the name, or rather in the time of coronavirus. Next up, from the Wall Street Journal, an exclusive story that is certainly in the pots and kettles category, as Boeing chief executive David Calhoun predicted that a major U.S. airline would fall by literally the autumn due to the fallout from the coronavirus health scandal. The airline industry, American, United, were just aghast at this statement, and they called on Boeing CEO to pull back from this. If a major U.S. carrier goes out of business, well, that seems to be not good for Boeing, and it's certainly not good for the flying public. So it's unclear why a company that claimed it needed $60 billion bailout, only to find out, lo and behold, they could raise their own money, would now say that one of their largest customers is going to go belly up. But it's not the way to influence friends and people. So perhaps Boeing CEO needs to reread his Dale Carnegie. In very disturbing news, the new head of the Postal Service, the Trump lackey and top donor, has begun a review of its package delivery contracts and no doubt will jack up prices to really take a toll on the U.S. mail-using public. Of course, this will only hasten the demise of the Postal Service, as the increased cost will not be something people are going to be willing to put up with when there are many other ways to transport packages. So the destruction that the Trump administration has wrought on many U.S. Governmental agencies and departments now moves to the Postal Service. You would think people, that's one thing people would want. And finally, from Reuters, the U.S. Fourth Circuit Court of Appeals has rejected Trump's bid to escape the corruption lawsuit around the emoluments clause. The decision by the Richmond-based Fourth Circuit Court, sitting as a whole or en banc, reverses a ruling in favor of Trump last July by a three-judge panel. The lawsuit alleged violation of the Constitution's emolument clauses, rarely tested in foreign court, that ban a president from accepting gifts or payments from foreign governments without congressional consent. So clearly Trump is taking money from foreign governments in the form of payments to his companies, which he has not relinquished control of. And just as clearly, this is influencing his decisions. If you want to get a favorable decision from Trump, just book a large number of rooms at any one of his hotels, or you could just go directly and make him a large campaign contribution. So hopefully the corruption will begin to slow down. This week on the FCPA Compliance and Ethics blog, I'm running a King Arthur-themed blog post week, so check it out. Coming up on this month's edition of The Compliance Life, I visit with Ellen Hunt. She's the CCO at AARP. We're going to have four episodes on Ellen's journey up to the CCO chair and beyond. The Daily Compliance News is a production of the Compliance Podcast Network and a proud member of C-Suite Radio. I hope you'll join me again tomorrow.